training deep learning models takes a lot of time. Luckily, you can resume the training of a model from where you left off and overcome the long training challenge. In this video, we'll show you how to save and load your model using Keras. We'll also explore the model checkpoint callback, which is a helpful technique used for training models. Let's start by loading up the dataset. To show how to save a model, we're going to use the MNIST dataset. This dataset consists of images of numbers. Before loading the MNIST dataset, let's first import TensorFlow and Keras. Let's write import TensorFlow as TF. After that, let's import Keras from TensorFlow. Nice, we imported the necessary libraries. Now, let's load the training and test datasets with the load data method in Keras. First, let's write the training input and output datasets, and then the test input and output datasets. Let's call the load data method from the Keras datasets class. Awesome, we loaded our datasets. Note that the training input and output datasets consist of 60,000 samples, and the test input and output datasets consist of 10,000 samples. Let's go ahead and perform data preprocessing. One of the most important steps of data analysis is data preprocessing. In deep learning, some data preprocessing techniques, such as normalization and regularization, improve the performance of the model. First, let's take the first 1,000 samples from these datasets to run the codes faster. Let's do this for the output variables first. Let's write a variable named train labels. After that, write the train label set and select the first 1,000 samples. Let's do it the same way for the test label set. Let's write a variable named test labels and then write the test label set and again select the first 1,000 samples. Great, we created the output variables. We're going to do the same for training data. The data samples consist of images of numbers. These images are two-dimensional. Before giving these samples to the model, let's convert them to a dimension with the reshape method. In addition, let's normalize the data to increase the performance of the model and to make the training faster. Let's write a variable named train images and then write the train images set and select the first 1,000 samples. After that, let's use the reshape method to convert two-dimensional images to a dimension. Finally, let's normalize the data by dividing it by 255. We're going to do the same for test inputs. Let's copy this code and paste it here. Let's write test instead of train like this and like this. Nice, our data sets are ready for the model. Let's go ahead and move on to the model building step. The easiest way to build a deep learning model is the sequential technique in Keras. In this technique, the layers are stacked one by one. What we're going to do now is define a function that contains our model. By doing this, we can easier build a model. Let's start by typing the def keyword. And then, let's write a variable named createModel. Next, let's build our model. To do this, we're going to call sequential from tf.keras. Now, we're going to pass our layers to this class. First, let's set the first dense layer from Keras. And then, let's pass 512 neurons to this layer. Next, for the activation parameter, let's give the relu function. For the input shape parameter, let's set the dimension of data, let's say 784. Nice, we created the first layer. Let's go ahead and create another layer. Let's set a dropout layer that randomly drops out 20% of the input units to help prevent overfitting. After that, we set a dense layer containing 10 neurons with no activation function. Awesome, we built the architecture of our model. Let's move on to compiling this model. To do this, let's call the compile method. After that, let's set atom to the optimizer parameter. Now, let's set the loss parameter. For this parameter, let's use sparse categorical cross-entropy from tf.keras.losses. And then, let's pass true to the from logits parameter. Lastly, we're going to set the metric parameter. For this parameter, let's use the sparse categorical accuracy metric from tf.keras.metrics. This is because our problem is classification. Finally, we use the return statement to return the compiled model. Awesome, we've defined a simple sequential model. Now, let's take an example object, named model, from this function. Let's write model and then let's set the name of our function. Nice, we built a model. Now, let's see the architecture of our model with the summary method. As you can see, our model consists of an input layer, a dropout layer, and an output layer. Let's move on to exploring the model checkpoint callback. You can save your model to reuse a model you have trained or to continue training where you left off. As you know, building a model actually means training the model's weights, called parameters. With the model checkpoint callback, you can save the weights of the model during model training. To illustrate this, let's instantiate an object from this callback. First, let's create the directory where the model will be saved with the OS module. Let's write import OS. And then, let's create a variable named checkpoint path. And let's get a path named training1, my checkpoints. Next, let's convert this variable into a directory with the OS module. Let's write checkpoint.dir, and then let's set os.path.dirname, and pass checkpoint path to this method. Nice, we've created our directory. Now, let's create a callback to save the weights of the model. Let's write checkpoint cb, and let's call the model checkpoint class, from tf.keras.callbacks. First, let's set the file path, and give the checkpoint path variable, to this parameter. Let's save only the weights of the model. To do this, we're going to use the save weights only parameter, and then pass true to this parameter. Great, we've created our callback. Now, let's call the fit method, and pass our callback to this method. Let's write model.fit, and then pass the train data sets, let's say train images, and train labels. And then, let's set the epoch number. Let's say 10. After that, let's set the validation data parameter. Let's pass the test data sets to this parameter. Let's give test images, and test labels. After that, let's set the callbacks parameter. And then, let's pass checkpoint CB to this parameter. When we run these codes, the training starts. Nice, we save the model weights in our directory. Note that the callback we use updates the checkpoint files at the end of each epoch. Let's look at the files in the directory, using the OS module. Let's use the os.lister method, and then, pass checkpoint.dir to it. As you can see, the weights were saved after the last epoch. Let's go ahead, and take a look at how to load weights. After you save the weights, you can load them into a model. Note that, you can only use the saved weights for models, with the same architecture. Let's instantiate an object to demonstrate this. Let's say model, and then write create model. Note that we have not yet trained the weights of this model. These weights were randomly generated. Now let's look at the accuracy score of this untrained model, on the test data with the evaluate method. Let's set the loss and accuracy variable. And then, let's call the evaluate method. And, let's pass the test data sets to this method. Let's say the test images and test labels. And, then let's set the verbose parameter. We're going to pass 2 to this parameter. Lastly, let's print the accuracy. Let's set print and pass the string. Let's say, F untrained model. Accuracy. After that, let's give 100 asterisk accuracy, and then let's set 5.2%. Let's run these codes. As you can see, the accuracy of the untrained model on the test data is about 10%. That's a pretty bad score, right? Now, let's load the weights we saved earlier with the load weights method, and then, look at the accuracy score of this model on the test data. Let's call the load weights method, and then, pass the checkpoint path variable. Awesome, we loaded the weights. Now, let's examine the performance of this model on the test set. To do this, let's use the same codes. Copy these codes, and paste it here. And let's run these codes. As you can see, it turned out that the accuracy of the model was around 90%. In this section, we have seen how to save model weights and how to load them. Now let's go ahead and explore how to save the whole model. After you train your model, you can want to deploy that model. To save the model's architecture, weights, and training configuration in a single file, you can use the save method. You can save your model in two different formats, save model and HDF5. Keep in mind that, in Keras the saved model format, is used by default. Let's save our final model. Let's create a directory for it. Let's write mkdir, and then save model. Now, let's save our model in this file. Let's type model, and call the save method. And, let's pass the directory to this method. Let's say saved model, my model. Great, we saved our model. Let's look at the files in this directory. Let's write ls, and then saved model, my model here. You can see files and subdirectories. You don't need the source code of the model to put the model into production. Saved model is sufficient for deployment. Let's take a closer look at these files. The saved model.pd file contains the model's architecture and computational graphics. The Keras metadata.pb file contains extra information required by Keras. The variables subdirectory contains parameter values such as weight and bias. The assets subdirectory contains extra files such as the names of attributes and classes. Nice, we saw how to save the entire model. Now let's see how to load the model. You can load the saved model with the load model method. To do this, let's first create the model architecture and then load the model. Let's write new model. And then, let's set create model. After that, let's say new model, and then, let's call the load method from tf.keras.models. We're going to pass the directory, let's say, saved model, my model, awesome, we have loaded the model. Let's look at the architecture of this model. To do this, we're going to write the new model variable, and then call the summary method. Here, you can see the architecture of the model. Note that, this model is compiled, with the same arguments as the original model. Let's look at the accuracy of this model on test data. To do this, we're going to use codes we used before. Let's copy these codes and paste them here. Let me adjust this text. Okay, let's run these codes. As you can see, the accuracy score of the model we saved on the test data is 87%. You can also save the model in H5 format, but most TensorFlow deployment tools require the saved model format. Yeah, that's it. When training a model, you can save your model to pick up where you left off. By saving the model, you can also share your model and allow others to recreate your work. In this video, we covered how to save and load deep learning models. First, we learned how to save model weights with the model checkpoint callback. Next, we saw saving and loading the entire model to deploy the model. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any questions. You can find the link to the notebook here. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, and like the video. We also create content on our other social media accounts. We will be happy if you follow us. See you in the next video. Bye for now.